Most businesses don't want to profit from EV chargers. They just want it done. And that's your opportunity. You install it, manage it, and keep 100% of the money.
Real quick before we dive in, whether you're starting an EV charging business or installing EV chargers at your condo or workplace, I've put together a ton of tools, resources, and video trainings to help you out. If you're an entrepreneur, these will help you move faster and make real money in the EV charging space. And if you're planning an installation, they'll save you thousands in costly mistakes. This is priceless knowledge from years of experience that you won't find anywhere else. And every time you support what I'm doing, it keeps me going and drives me to keep sharing all the insider tips about this market. Everything's linked below. All right, let's go.
This was one of my biggest realizations when I was first starting out in the EV charging industry. I always thought that it'd be such a big selling point that these businesses like restaurants or these workplaces could potentially make an extra profit from EV chargers, but I quickly found out that this wasn't a big deal to them. And not only was it not a big deal, it was actually something that they didn't want to deal with. So yeah, you can definitely make a profit if you own a business and you install a couple EV chargers for the public to use, but you know, with everything, there's pros and cons, right? So let's say you own, you know, a store, let's say like just a general hardware store, and you had people coming and going all the time to stop into your store and buy supplies for whatever they needed for their projects, right? And this is a storefront, so people are literally coming to the store and they're parking their car. They're leaving their car there for, I don't know, half an hour maybe, while they go through and figure out everything that they need. And as they're sitting there, if they drive an electric car, they could just plug in and you could, as the business owner, start making a bit of a profit off of reselling the electricity, right? But here's what I was hearing from these business owners. Yeah, it's great. It's great to have an amenity to be able to offer for our customers, but that is one more thing that we're gonna have to deal with and manage and make sure that it's working properly. And I remember talking to this one manager. He's like, "Man, do you know how much I already have to deal with?" He's like, "I can't learn how to operate these EV chargers and figure out what to do if something goes wrong or who to call." He's like, "That just terrifies me, having to deal with one more thing." He's like, "I'm already at my capacity trying to manage this place." And that's when I started to realize, like, okay, fair enough. It's not that they don't want the chargers. They would love to have the amenity of these chargers, but it's just the fear of this new concept and having to manage everything. And yeah, the profits are great, but the profits aren't necessarily big enough to cover the concerns and what they perceive as the amount of time or hours it would take to deal with any problems that might come up. And this is great. This is great for us as we start our new EV charging business. This is actually a huge opportunity for us, because I think what's been happening so far with all these other really big established EV charging companies, and you know, sometimes you hear, "Oh, these EV charging companies are losing money," or "They're not growing as quickly as you'd think they would be." And there's a bunch of reasons for this. I mean, it's not always the case. There's lots of EV charging companies that are doing really well, but there are a few that might not be growing as quickly as they were hoping or people thought they would. And it's mostly to do with their business model. And with the profits from EV chargers, let's say we had, you know, a prime location, there was lots of EVs in the area, huge demand, they're being used a lot. Then if we're looking at, you know, a great location and the stars align, we could be making, let's say, $5,000 in profit per year from this charger. But also sometimes the profit per year could be, you know, substantially less if it's not in a great area or there's not a huge demand, right? So there's lots of different swinging factors, but the biggest thing for us is the install cost. So if the charger's only making $1,000 a year, but it only costs us $1,000 to install, then it's all good. We're breaking even in a year. We're happy. But that's not usually the case. With these businesses, often these chargers are placed outside. So this means they'll have to dig up all the concrete, and we have to trench up all that concrete. I've seen install costs like 20, 30, 40 grand. It can get insane sometimes. And when those install costs are that high, then of course there's no way that the EV charging company will say, "Yeah, we'll pay for it." If we're only making, you know, a couple $1,000s in profit, it'll take us forever to break even. So that's why with our EV charging company, we want to be super selective about the locations that we choose. We're looking for that super low install cost, And we also want to have high utilization. So lots of people in the area that are using our chargers. And in that case, then we can offer Mr. Manager, the guy that I just spoke about, who is all stressed out, we can give him a great solution. Let's say his install only cost us 10 grand to put two of those chargers in. He's right off a super busy street. There's tons of people visiting. And let's say they're tradespeople and they're driving electric trucks now because, you know, it's a lot cheaper. Beautiful. Then we know that we're going to have a pretty profitable chargers that are used at pretty high rates here. And in that case, we go to Mr. Manager and we say, listen, all those concerns you have, don't worry about it. We'll take care of everything. You're not going to have to pay for any of the install, any of the charging. If anything goes wrong, we will know before you do because we can manage everything and see it on the back end. You won't even need to lift a finger and call us. If there's any concerns from your customers, then they can deal with us. We'll deal with them. We'll take care of it. If anything, this is just going to make you more money through bringing in more customers to your location. They're staying longer, which means they're going to be spending more money. And one thing that people don't usually mention is there's also those EV charging maps like PlugShare. So let's say I was a contractor or I needed to go to this hardware store and I thought I knew all the different hardware stores in the area. But one day I was looking for an EV charger and I opened my PlugShare app and I see, oh, hey, there's a charger here at this business. Let's go check it out. It's like, oh, this is a hardware store. I had no idea. I've lived here forever. I had no idea. Like, boom, you just got a new customer. And it all came through the funnel or the channel of your EV charger. So there's tons of different benefits that we're providing you. And with all this value that we're providing you with very little risk, you don't have to manage anything. You don't have to pay for anything. So with this beautiful gift that we've given you to enhance your business, in return, we're going to ask to receive 100% of the profits that go into those EV chargers. And because we own the chargers, there are chargers, we paid for them, then we will also receive the rebate or the incentive from the government to help us pay for the chargers. And if we live in an area that has high rebates or high incentives, then we could be reimbursed for 40, 50% of the project, which is going to cut our break-even time in half. And I say all this because I think people have the wrong or maybe a negative perception of EV charging businesses. They think, you know, they're maybe not making a lot of money or they should be doing better. But if you do it right and if you look out for the right things and you're very strategic about all the moves that you make, you put yourself in a good position, then you can definitely make money in this business. And if you're looking to start your own EV charging business and need some tips or advice, I'm happy to help. As well, if you're a business and you're considering installing some chargers at your location for your customers, I'm also very happy to help. Feel free to give me a shout through my email. It's contact@strongenergy-ev.com. I can help you with some rough pricing. I can give you advice on the best charging companies to use in your area or what to look out for in terms of the electricians to use, but mostly just looking for some rough numbers and what you're looking at when you just get started. And as always, I'd love if you were to subscribe to the channel and keep following the journey. Thanks so much for checking in, and I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.